Hello again. The OpenMW team has released version 0.24.0. This release brings several features that push OpenMW much further in terms of playability, so let's have a look at what's new. The in-game menu now gives the option to start a new game. This is of course an option given by vanilla Morrowind, and makes it much less tedious to properly start a new game. For now, OpenMW will continue to initially start up in the cell Bashara for testing purposes, but by version 1.0, the main menu with options to start a new game or load a previous saved game will be shown on startup. The Athletics skill has been implemented, which is useful since Vordenfell's fast travel services don't always go all the way to the remote locations where an adventurer's quests may take them. The Escort AI packages have been implemented. These are used when an NPC escorts the player to a predetermined location. The player must follow the NPC, and the NPC will wait when the player strays too far away from them. One of the more prominent missing features impeding playability has been added in this version. The player may now open interior doors and simply walk through them rather than having to disable collision and float through them like the ghost of Nerevar. Now, once our characters can kill other living creatures with their own in-game hands rather than with the console, we'll be pretty close to playing a legitimate game of Morrowind with our new engine. When in dialogue with an NPC, the topic links and reply choices are now highlighted upon mouse over. Journal entries now have the correct titles and are marked with a timestamp. Also, the questline and topic indices have been added. Several trading enhancements have been made in this release. NPCs will now sell items in containers that belong to them, and certain NPCs will refuse service to the player under particular circumstances. For example, when the player is below the rank needed to access services provided by a member of a guild that they belong to. The magical effects of Blind and Night Eye have been implemented so that the player can make it a little easier for itself to see in the dark, or a little harder for its enemies to see at all. Or, if you like, you can don the boots of blinding speed and blind yourself, and be fast! There are some corpses in Morrowind that are meant to be persistent, and so one should not be able to dispose of them as they could most other corpses. OpenMW now recognizes and respects this feature. Animation layering is now implemented in OpenMW's animation systems. This allows the player and NPCs to do more than just move around and play idle animations. OpenMW now renders equipped tools, weapons, and shields, and the player may now assume the ready positions for combat and using magic. Actual combat and spellcasting are yet to be implemented, so unfortunately, one cannot swing their trusty blade around or cast their favorite spells. However, the security skill is fully implemented in this version, so feel free to pick locks and disarm traps until your heart's content. Currently, these animations only play in the third-person view. And that's it for now. As you can see, the project continues to move forward at a steady pace, so keep looking for future updates, and we'll report more progress soon. As always, thanks for watching.